Well, so a 14-year-old boy in Pinellas County was just arrested for making threats about being a potential mass shooter at his high school. And you know, it's interesting. He posted this stuff on Instagram.
Yeah.
And you know, I want you guys to comment and tell us whether you really believe this is a real threat of somebody being an active shooter. So let's see exactly what this kid posted. So this was post number one. He said, what's up, Dixie? And he goes to the Dixie Hollins High School in Pinellas County. So, you know, I don't think that's really super bad. A picture of an AK-47, probably questionable for them to be posting that for the school.
For a 14-year-old to be posting that, especially with kind of what's, you know, what's happened in the past and stuff. So a little questionable, but not...
But that's not like super crazy.
Right.
The next one is a little bit interesting. So the next one says, wouldn't go to school tomorrow. Okay, that's, you know,
now you put it with the other one, and it's like two and two make you.
Yeah, like this is getting a little bit crazy. So somebody says freedom of speech. Okay, sure, freedom of speech has a place. Yep. But also, if you say certain things, it's going to make us think, you know, maybe I got to go look at that dude.
Yeah.
Right? Maybe I got to go pay attention to him.
And that's, we were, you know, discussing this beforehand. There is freedom of speech, and we don't want to step on that. But where do you draw that line?
I don't know. Let's see the last post and then let's get everybody's opinion. So here's the last post. Can't wait to see you or see those. So comment below. These are the three posts that this 14-year-old put on Instagram. Okay. Does this constitute a threat in your opinion? What do you think?
I would have to say, especially after seeing what happened in Parkland, that the shooter had posted kind of similar stuff.
Yeah, so Nicholas Cruz posted on Snapchat, I believe, a video of himself saying, I'm going to be a professional school shooter.
Now, that was a little bit more, obviously, a little bit, you know, he was saying. He
very
was,
blatant he, yeah, about very what his blatant, intent
that's
was.
That's the word I was looking for. But let me ask you this, you know, if something happened at that school.
Sure.
Okay. And then
we found those posts
after the fact and they didn't do anything. What would people say?
Yeah. The entire gun community, everybody would be saying like your red flag, that it was there. It was there.
There were flag, you know, exactly.
Now here's what ended up happening. So the detectives, this person had set up a fake Instagram account.
Okay.
So they were able to figure out based on the phone number, I guess he linked with the Instagram account.
Okay.
They were able to figure out who the teenager was. They determined that he downloaded these images from the internet and that he has zero access to guns.
Okay.
I think it's concerning. I think everybody needs to understand that we live in a interesting time where school shootings are happening and you can't just post dumb stuff like this on the internet. Even when you're upset, you're frustrated, you got to pay attention. And make sure you're not...
Yeah, I agree. So what did they do? They investigated him and then...
Yeah, they arrested him.
Okay, they arrested
him. They brought him in and I'm sure they brought the parents in, whoever he lives with, right? And then they determined that there are no guns actually there.
Okay.
So how exactly is he supposed to carry out this active shooting threat if he doesn't actually have access to any guns? Now, it doesn't mean that there are no guns. It could be a situation like us where all the guns are in a safe.
Right.
And the kid simply doesn't have access to the safe. If it was my kid that posted that stuff on Instagram, I would beat the crap out of
them. Well, I think he was talking about like if his kids went to that
school. No, I understand. Oh, you wouldn't let him go to school. Yeah. I get that.
Oh, if that was our kid, I mean.
I wouldn't let him go to school either because it's just too risky, right?
Yeah. But yeah, if that was our kids that said something.
Yeah, they wouldn't walk
like
correctly
that.
For a while.
Yeah.
It would be.
It's a serious thing, and that's what people need to understand. Remember, there was that other kid that had done something, and the police went there, and the mom was like, oh, he's just a kid. He's just a kid. And it's like, no, he's not just a kid. He's a teenager, and, he's making threats, and.
You have to be held accountable to this stuff, right?
You can't do that. You got to stop it. So stop it in its tracks.